For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Líbranos de aquel que nos domina en la miseria. Tráenos tu reino de justicia e igualdad.
Thousands of musicians gather in Santiago, Chile, every year in the month of September for the event titled 1000 Guitars for Victor Jara. The event is organized to pay homage to the iconic musician Victor Jara, who was tortured and killed immediately after the coup in September 1973. Victor Jara was an active member of the Chilean Communist Party and a supporter of Salvador Allende's Popular Unity government. In the 1970s, left-wing political parties across Chile formed a coalition called Popular Unity under the leadership of Salvador Allende. Allende was one of the first Marxist presidents elected by popular vote, and in his less than 3 years in office, carried forward important socialist policies to better the lives of Chileans. Allende's election campaign was supported actively by the New Song Movement. The New Song Movement that emerged in the 1960s in Chile was rooted in popular musical traditions that were passed down through generations. They incorporated elements from the indigenous folk traditions of the Andes and the folk music of the downtrodden. The New Song Movement revolutionized the musical culture of Chile. Victor Jara was one of the key figures of the movement. The CIA and its lackeys in the Chilean military orchestrated a coup against Salvador Allende in 1973. On September 11, the armed forces of Chile occupied the capital city of Santiago and surrounded the presidential headquarters and began to attack it with tanks and bombed it with British Hawker Hunter jets. When a contingent of soldiers went to knock down the door of the presidential palace, Salvador Allende supposedly surrendered and committed suicide, though the full truth of what happened is still unknown. Following the coup, the civic military dictatorship led by Augusto Pinochet was in power for 16 and a half years, during which thousands were brutally murdered and tens and thousands were tortured. Santiago's National Stadium was the largest detention center. Victor Jara was among the many who lost their lives in the stadium. On the morning of September 12, Jara was taken prisoner, along with thousands of others, and put in the National Stadium. At the stadium, he started singing to keep up the spirits of the other political prisoners. The guards asked him to stop singing, but he did not. Finally, they thrashed him with their guns and shot him. His body was found near the stadium a few days later with 44 bullets in it. 45 years after the murder of iconic Chilean folk singer Victor Jara, a court finally convicted 9 military officers of his murder in July 2018. In a ruling of 342 pages, Miguel Vasquez Plaza, the judge of the Court of Appeals in Santiago, sentenced 8 retired officers, Hugo Sanchez, Raul Jofre, Edwin Dimter, Nelson Ace, Ernesto Betke, Juan Jara, Hernan Chacon, and Patricio Vasquez, to 15 years and a day in prison for the murders and another 3 years in jail for the crime of kidnapping the victims. Victor was an example of resistance. He symbolized the idea that art and progressive politics should converge to strengthen people's resistance. The resistance of Victor Jara in Chile and Safdar Hashmi, who was a victim of state violence in India, and many others, continue to inspire the spirit of revolutionaries around the world in their everyday struggles.
Y así verás tu canto y tu bandera.